Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm recording about Neo4j Data Science Library. I will speak about topological link prediction algorithms. As the name indicates, these algorithms help us to predict if the two nodes have a relationship in between them or if they gonna have a prediction in the future. The algorithms just produce an score which determine how close, according to some calculations, are these two nodes in the graph. All these calculations are done looking at the relationships that has the nodes and their neighbors, and they are not looking at any parameter and to any attribute that the nodes nodes or relationships had. It's purely looking at how the nodes are connected in between them. All the algorithms in this category are in alpha status. I give you here a link what exactly means this in Neo4j. So they are experimental. So this, as I mentioned before in other videos, is better not to use this unless at the minimum they are in beta tier, which means that they may go to production quality. The reason that they are in alpha and they are for some time already in alpha is probably because there is not a lot of interest, something that is quite strange because some of them are broadly used in especially in social networks. But well, is again that is the status of today in April 2024. So my advice, just you can play around, understand how they work, and we will probably use them in some stuff in the machine learning pipelines. But as you will see, when we go to the details, they are not integrated completely. It's in the alpha class, in the alpha module. And then you cannot create projections with them, and then just you apply it directly. In any case, this is only producing a score, and well, all of them are working exactly the same. And the only thing that changes is the calculations that the algorithm to calculate the score. So let's start. So I'm working, I create this notebook. Later I will upload it to the repository as usual. You will be able to play around with that. I'm working with the Neo4j sandbox database with the data science template. And as you probably know, as I mentioned in previous videos, this database comes by default with a database, an example database that is the airports. It's all the airports in the world. And then let me show you, if you didn't see the previous videos, it comes with this database with 5 different nodes. Forget node and station. This is for some other examples. It comes with airport, city, country, and continent. And with the relationships hash route in city, in country, in region, and on continent. Hash route weight is, I made it for a previous video, and connection and rel relation is I also created in previous videos. And so there is multiple properties here in the section properties. You had properties either from nodes or for relationship. Okay, let's start. The first one is Adamic Adar index. I give you here some links in how is calculated this score is essentially based in calculating the is calculating the closeness based on the shared neighborhoods, safe neighbors that had these two nodes, and then applying this formula, and then only give us a value which means that when the value is close to zero, means that there is that the nodes are not close, and when the value is higher even than zero, means that the higher than one, sorry, that the nodes are closer. As higher the value, the closer the nodes are. So I make some examples here applying the Adamir-Adar algorithm with these two helpers, which had first of all, neighbor, the concept neighbor here, as you probably know, is a node which had a direct connection to the node that you are evaluating. For example, if P2 is neighbor of P1, this means that there is a relation, whatever, in between P1 and P2. The direction, depending if the direction is unidirectional or bidirectional, if will apply in both directions or in just in one direction. But the neighbor, the simple definition is that we had a connection, a direct connection in between both nodes. So we are applying this. This is these two nodes doesn't have a direct connection in between them. Sorry, they had shared neighborhoods, sorry, but they don't have probably many through the main one. The main relationship in this graph is hash road, which means that there is a direct fly in between airports. They probably have neighbors in some other, for example, in each region or in each country, in those within those relationships, probably they have common neighbors, but in the principal one, which is each road, they don't have. So that's why we receive a low score. These two airports are one in Oceania, in the Pacific Ocean, and the other one is in Africa. They don't have any neighbors in common at all, so the score is zero. This means that the no likelihood to have a relationship in between them. Here we have Dallas and Anchorage that Steven. They are also in the same region in USA, and they have probably even they had a road in common, so the score is higher. They probably had even a direct connection in between them. Here we had Dallas and Los Angeles, and then on when you limit the calculations to some of the or to one of the relationships, as you see here, hash road, which means that we had a direct flight in between the nodes, you can see here that the score is very high, because looking at this, they probably have all the neighbors had the connections with them, so there is a lot of shared neighbors looking at this relationship. In the other hand, if we look at the relation in city, which means Los Angeles Airport is in the city Los Angeles, but in this relationship, there is no additional neighbors. The same happens with Dallas. In this relationship, Dallas, through the relationship in city, only had a neighbor, which is the city Dallas, and there is no further neighbor. So when we go to do the calculations, the score is zero, because there is no common neighbors in between these two cities. So it's important. So if you don't specify anything, the algorithm is going to look at all the relationships that had every node. If you specify the relationship, only or limit the calculations to only the relationship that you specify in the parameter relationship query. And again, scores close to zero means that they are not close, and also means that it is not possible or is very unlikely to have a relationship in between these two nodes, which makes sense because this relationship is just creating the relation from the airport to the city where the airport is located, and there is no possibility at all that ever the Dallas airport will be in Los Angeles and vice versa. Common neighbors is another algorithm which essentially captures the idea that two nodes that had a node in common, a neighbor in common, is most likely to be connected. It's not now, in the future. So it's looking at the number of nodes that we share, that we had in common, and made a similar calculation. You provide as well a score, and we replicate as well the exercise or the calculation for the same example that above. And similarly here, you get a graphs of how likely or how close are Dallas and Dillingham, because probably they had some airports in common through the hash road relationship. Here, these two in Oceania and Africa, no way, there is nothing in common, no neighbors in common. Here, Dallas and Los Angeles, through the relationship hash road, you get a score very high, and the same calculation but using the in-city, as it couldn't be in other way, zero. Preferred attachment is another calculation that measures the closeness of the nodes looking at the shared neighbors. Similar to the previous ones, different calculation that is done, but the meaning is slightly different how we interpret here the score, because just looking at the outputs, Dallas and Dillinger, they had a number of the shared neighbors. Tontura in Oceania and Nador in Africa, they may have some neighbors in common, which is not that we are, that in this case, sorry, it was a mistake, because here is something that is incorrect, I will fix it. The preferential attachment is based on the idea that nodes that had more connections are more likely to receive new connections, and this means that it's more likely that either we are connected or will be connected in the future. I will remove this because it's drive me to confusion. It's not working like that. It's based on the idea of nodes, in this case airports, which had multiple connections through the links or through the relationships they have, are more likely to be connected to other nodes, and then not now, but in the future, that in the future it will be even a relationship in between two nodes. This is like the example of, for example, football players, which had a lot of connections, and it will be really likely to be connected to another football player, which also has a lot of connections. So here, and to understand now how this is work, look at the examples that are the same that above. If you look at Dallas and Dillingham, they are unleash Dallas is had a lot of the connections, and then this means that the score, the calculations, doing the calculation, we will get a high score. Even doing with two airports that are not even connected through any neighbors, we get a score. The only limitations, as you see here, is using or limiting to the relationship that you want to use to do the calculations. We look at the Dallas and Los Angeles, and looking at the or limiting the calculations to the relationship hash road, obviously we will get a very big score, a very high number, because Dallas has a lot of connections, and also Los Angeles has a lot of connections, and then once we do the calculation, that is basically a multiplication, pues we get a lot of the a high score. In the other hand, is what I mentioned before. So we can take a look, we can make a calculation. This is only the number of the relationships that had node A by the number of relationships had the node B. So we get here this number. This means that this is this these calculations, this multiplication in between these two numbers is getting a number high. Here, if we consider this relationship, there is only one from Dallas to the using the in-city relationship. There is only one link to, from Dallas to the city Dallas, and another one Los Angeles to the city Los Angeles. So one by one is one. So that's why we get an score of one. You see, it's very easy to understand how to interpret the numbers. In this case, there is and is at the end understanding the how is done the calculation. You get a grasp as well how this is work. So there is, as with the other calculation, there is no way to do here like here. We get a zero. There is no possibility to have a relationship, which essentially makes sense. Well. It's never gonna be a relationship in between Dallas and the city of Los Angeles and vice versa. Now resource allocation is another algorithm, and is doing another a different calculation, but at the end of the day as well based on the number of share or share neighbors that a specific node has. It's pretty similar to the first we look at here. You look at the calculation that we are doing here. It's pretty similar to the one we do here. So we had the neighbors in common, and there we apply the logarithm, and here we apply the number of shared neighbors. So that's why some of the scores are smaller, but the meaning is exactly the same that we have here in the Adar algorithm. Yes, is the magnitude of the score is different, but the meaning is exactly the same. So here we get an score which is above zero, meaning that there is some closeness. Same here, no closeness. Using the hash road means that we got a bigger score, which makes sense. It's also in line with the calculations that we did here. 0.46, in this case we got 0.2413. Which essentially are pretty similar to these ones. And again, here using the in-city relationship, we get an score of zero. So it's pretty similar to the Adar algorithm. The only thing that changed is this denominator in this calculation. So the numbers that you are going to get are in other magnitude or is slightly different. Same community is just basically, it's pretty simple algorithm, which is basically in a previous run of a community detection algorithm. We look at this on a previous video, so we need to run previously a community detection algorithm, organize all the nodes in the graph according to some attributes in communities, and then when we had this community detection algorithm ready and run, we write back the values to as parameters to the nodes in the database. So this means that we will get a new parameter per node with the name of community, by default is community, and we will use this parameter together with the relationships in between nodes to detect, yeah, to predict it, to, sorry, to calculate the closeness in between these two nodes. Essentially, it's pretty simple to understand. If you are in the same community, you will get a value above zero. If you are not in the same community, you will get a value of zero. And in this case, as we don't have the community, I didn't run this, so we couldn't follow the four examples. But you can get an idea of how they work. First of all, run the community detection, assign every node to a community. This means that we have a parameter community because it's what the algorithm is looking at together with the relationships in between them. And then on, but the simple thing that you may understand, if zero means that essentially you are not in the same community, and if you get a value of one, you are in the same community and you may have a relationship with other nodes in the same community. And total neighbors is the last one. Is based on the total number of neighbors that both nodes have, and this means that the nodes is pretty similar to another that we saw before, that based it the union of the neighbors of node A and node B, node X, node Y, and the higher is this value, the closer that the nodes could be. And then we apply the formula, the algorithm, to our examples, and you can get a graphs as well of the numbers, pretty similar anyway. So here again, it doesn't matter that they are shared neighbors or not shared neighbors. Just we look at the relationships, we count how many nodes are neighbors, looking at all the relationships. If we don't specify relationship query of every single node, we sum up both and then we get a score. And then here we get a score of 258. This means that these two nodes have 258 neighbors in total, looking to all the relationships they had. Whatever they has, hash route, weight, hat, whatever they had, this is as simply a sum up. And then on here, remember that these two airports are in two different continents, so they just sum up the number of neighbors, looking at all the relationships that they have. Here we do the same calculation, but just limiting or filtering to just those that had the through the relationship hash route, and we get Dallas, Los Angeles, 330. And the same, you remember this example that we look at here, which they make a multiplication, and then on we get here the same, just we had two neighbors, they are the two cities where these two airports are located. Well, that's all. Interesting stuff as well. Still a little bit immature, at least on Neo4j. There is a lot of stuff done already. This algorithm, for example, was created, as you see, in 2003. So is the algorithms are not not they are re- not new. If you can say that, is not, they are some kind of mature. They are pretty much used on social networks. And but Neo4j, for some reasons, well, still have it in a very early stage. As from my knowledge, still is they are not progressing very fast in this area. My suspicion is there is not many clients demanding the use of these algorithms in Neo4j. We'll see in the future. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it and it's useful, this content, for you. And if that's the case, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much. Bye.